morning, good afternoon, and of course, good evening, traders from across the globe. Thank you, as always, for tuning in to my 2430th edition of Short Term Trading Live with Oscar. All right, traders, so remember the risks involved in this game. Do not trade without stops. Put them in first. I don't care what vehicle you use, from crypto to options and everything in between. They're all risky, so please put your stops in first. All right, traders, we've got some topics on the board for trading on June 22nd, 2022. First one is, do not fall in love with the upside. I know we're going up. We went up today on Tuesday. Was today Tuesday? On Tuesday, do not fall in love with the upside. For now, that remains valid. Rallies that go up high enough will end up being sold. We're still raising interest rates. Number two on the board, there are gaps above in the ES and NQ charts on the daily charts. We know we left gaps, right? It's a rare occasion ES will leave a gap. Maybe this week the gaps get filled. But number three, be very nimble with long positions in ESNQ. In other words, if you do get long, if the OmniX get long, if you get long with us, if you get long on your own, make sure that when it rallies up and hits a profit objective, you get out, because we are in a bear segment right now. So you want to be quick with profits if you're long. And then there's this. Does wheat have dandruff? I don't know. I think it does. Big head and shoulders formation on the daily chart, which I would love to show to you. Traders, I'm having an OmniCamp here in Las Vegas, September 8th through 12th. I've got three open seats, and I'd like for you to qualify for those seats. Make sure you come to livewithoscar.com, or better than that, just go to omnibootcamp.com and fill out your applications, and I will call you and qualify you for one of my three open seats. That is September 8th through 12th, held here live in Las Vegas. Fill out those applications. All right, so you've seen, or we discussed the topics on the board. This is all for trading on Wednesday. I am going to say it again, be very nimble with long positions. We are going to get long because the Omni is telling us to, but be very nimble with your long positions. Now, right before we do the chart segment, just a little treat for you traders. I seen it, I couldn't stop laughing. I know it's not brand new, but I seen it again tonight. Made me laugh, and I thought I would show it to you. Then we'll go look at some charts. I want to ride my Okay, traders, your E-mini S&P daily bar chart. We know we've got a gap up here, right? Near the 37.95 area. We certainly have a gap there somewhere. Actually, it's near the 38.95 area. You got a long way to go. So, market would have to go all the way up there to fill that gap. What we did do is we got above this resistance I was showing you in last night's video. We never traded yesterday, so it didn't matter to us, but we got above that resistance. The boss settled here, and now we've got the Omni telling us to buy dips. So I will be extremely nimble because we are in a downward segment, but the Omni says buy dips, and buy dips we will do, and hopefully they try to run up and fill that gap. NASDAQ, same thing. You've got the gap in the NASDAQ right there. You need to get the market up here to fill that gap. So if we get a pullback first, we will buy and expect to get up to that, at least the gap area, where, of course, I would want to be getting out to see what's going to happen next. But hopefully we'll get a fill and it'll rally and we'll go from there. Now, traders, the NASDAQ and the S&P both have gaps. But if you look, the Russell's got no gap to go up and fill. So the Russell just barely made it out of the resistance. It's right there. It barely made it out. And it has no gap to go up there and fill. So I'm telling you right now, be very nimble with long trades, because Russell, of all three, does not look like it needs to go much higher. Although the Russell's going to follow what everything else does, and Omni says buy the dips. Now, there is this. Crude oil has dropped from $123 a barrel all the way down to $106 already. Now, that huge adjustment, you know what? That gives relief to the stock market. So maybe this will be a catalyst to fill the gaps in the stock market that we just looked at. The price of crude coming down, right? That's a relief for all of us. Maybe that's enough for the stocks to adjust up and go fill the gap. Then there's this interesting chart. Look at the wheat. You've got a left shoulder head, right shoulder. You've broken down from that. Omni's telling me to sell it. Head and shoulders, seems like wheat has dandruff here. It's got a head and shoulders formation. So we will sell the rallies in wheat if we get filled. And then if you expect wheat to go down, you'd certainly want to see dollars going up. Here's your dollar index chart, right? If dollars go up, remember, a lot of commodities are on a teeter-totter, if you will. And you've got dollars on one side and wheat on the other, right? A little teeter-totter. Well, if that teeter-totter, if one went up, the other would go down, right? Dollars down, wheat up. Well, the opposite effect also takes place. If you have dollars go up, wheat goes down. So we've got a bull look, at least a bull flag look on the US dollar. And I just showed you the wheat chart with the head and shoulders pointing lower. So I say dollar moves higher, forcing wheat lower. I like those trades. OmniX, I want you to join me at livewithoscar.com. Remember to keep your emotions out of trading and say this to yourselves every day and night. It'll help you when you're in your trades. Are you ready? Stops are in. Emotions are out. Thanks for tuning in. Good luck trading out there. I'll see you all at livewithoscar.com.